Everyone, sorry for the quick change of content. I promise my channel will stay dedicated to the van content, but I keep getting requests in my Pioneer radio fix video for this. If you don't have a broken Pioneer head unit, kindly disregard this video. So, if your AVH4400NEX is stuck in the boot loop, that probably means the internal SD card has gone corrupt. To remove the SD card, see my other video, and make sure to read Scott Nielsen's pinned comment on top. I ended up doing a few unnecessary steps since there were no guides on the removal process or even the SD card location at the time. Now, you can purchase a new SD card with the internal files preloaded from eBay, or, thanks to James I75 on the AVIC411 forms, you can now load these files yourself onto a new SD card. Shout out to Honda R for putting this guide together, and it's linked in the description, which has everything you will need. Aside from purchasing a new SD card, you'll need to go buy a 16GB or larger SD card, and for the SD card speed, class 4 is going to be the minimum, but the higher the read and write speeds, the better. Next, download the files from this link. It's going to take a little while, so be patient. And once it's downloaded, go ahead and right-click and extract the files. Now, you'll also need to go back to Honda R's post and download the Win32 disk imager to write this file to the SD card. You cannot simply drag and drop the file to the SD card. That will not work. So once the Win32 disk imager is installed, simply select the image file you just downloaded, and then over here on the right, select the drive, which is your SD card. That's going to be the destination that it's going to, and click write. Wait a little bit for that to write to the card. Your computer might freak out a little bit at the end since it's going to say this SD card is now corrupt. It's not corrupt, it just can't be read by your computer, which is fine. Your radio will read it, and it should fix your boot loop issue. Do not format it or do any other thing in the computer besides remove it. Huge shout out to the AVIC411 forum again for these resources. Hope this video helped. See ya.